Have you seen those videos of sand patterns appearing when you vibrate a metal plate at a specific frequency? Welcome to a short introduction to the study of the visualization of sound, also known as cymatics. What is sound? Sound involves the ordered vibration of atoms at a certain temperature, exchanging frequency data in space via the collision of neighboring atoms. For instance, this happens when sound travels in the air. An everyday example of vibrations is a ripple in a lake. However, audible sound happens in three dimensions and approximately in a spherical manner, similar to a bubble. The pulsations of a sound resemble a wave, but have the form of a bubble, meaning it forms a flexible sphere that expands at the speed of sound. Moreover, each point on the surface of the sound bubble contains the vibrational information of the total sound bubble, displaying what is called holographic properties. So what is a wave? In physics, a wave consists of the propagation of a perturbation of some property in space. For example, density, pressure, electric field or a magnetic field. It involves the transportation of energy without the transport of matter. Did you hear that? Sound waves belong to a more general group known as mechanical waves, which need a medium to propagate, unlike other types of waves, such as electromagnetic waves. So first, we need to define what is a standing wave in order to understand the effect of sound waves in a medium. So what are standing waves? A standing wave is an oscillatory disturbance in which certain points, called nodes, remain stationary. A standing wave is formed by the interference of two waves of the same nature with equal amplitudes, wavelength, and frequency, traveling in the opposite direction through a medium. Importantly, standing waves remain confined in a space, such as a string, a tube with air, or on a membrane. Moreover, the amplitude of the oscillation at each point varies over time. Yet the frequency remains the same for all points and coincides with that of the interfering waves. As mentioned earlier, there are points that do not vibrate, called nodes. Those remain motionless and stationary, while others, the bellies or the antinodes, move to a maximum vibrational amplitude and energy, equal to the sum of the interfering waves. So the study of sound waves as a visual phenomena is called cymatics. The cymoscope instrument, invented by John Stuart Reed, represents sound waves in its purest form, regardless of the medium it is traveling through. This is because the medium constrains the sound propagation. And to obtain the dispersion of sound in its purest form, the cymoscope removes any presence of a natural resonance of a medium with electronic filtering, and then shines a light on the vibrating water to reveal the stationary wave pattern corresponding to that sound. This allows for a more accurate and reliable analysis of sound. In other words, without the influence of the medium in which it is propagating. To learn more about the science of cymatics and its applications, have a look at the links that are in the description below. Thanks for watching.